Another project developed in the EPS program. It's called an aquaponic system. My presentation is outlined like this, so I will also start with a brief introduction, then the state of the arts, and after that the project developments and tests that were developed and some conclusions. So regarding the introduction, so we have already spoken here, and my colleague Benedita has already introduced the EPS program. So in EPS, what we try to develop is projects that are challenging for students. So usually are projects that try to fit into the challenges for the 21st century or the engineering challenges for the 21st century and also the United Nations goals for the millennium. So we always try to find projects on those areas. And so in 2014 we offered a project that was an aquaponic system that should incorporate eco-friendly, sustainable technologies. And this project was chosen by a multinational team, as usual, with five students from five different countries and five different fields of study. And the students themselves, they stated that they were all interested in creating an aquaponic system. And they saw that it was a system that was becoming even more popular throughout the world. And they also had this idea that they could develop a product or a project that would be of some interest in poor regions where water is a very valuable resource, and they could bred fish and also grow plants all with the same water. And so this was the idea that drove this team of students. And so they start by developing a study of the state of the art, and usually what they learn is that aquaponics is something that unites hydroponics, so growing plants without need to add soil, and also
fish farm,
I'm already tired. So in the same circuit with the same water we can feed fish, then the breeze from the fish they get into the water, and instead of dropping the water out and putting new water inside of the system, we just dump the water into a system where we have the plants. The plants absorb those nutrients, and then the water, after filtered by the plant's roots, goes back into the tank, and the system runs. Ideally, it should run on a closed circuit, but in fact, there are some losses of water, and we have to put more water in the system. So this is the basic idea of aquaponics. So this has some advantages, so we don't need to use fertilizers and chemicals in the plants for growing them, and we also don't pollute the water because we can filter the water through the plants. And so the students, during their state of the art, they were looking for aquaponic systems that were on the market. They found that there were some companies already in this market, but mainly companies developing large-scale products, and mainly in the United States and Australia. There were no commercial producers in Europe, at least that they found. And so, after checking all the players, they decided, because here the projects are open, so they have to, we give them the idea that they have to devise the product. So they decided that they were going to develop a small indoor aquaponic system that everyone could have in the kitchen, for instance, to keep in some fish. Probably not with the fishes, just to have an aquarium, but to grow some aromatic plants. And so this was their idea. And so they started the project development. So their goal was very open. They just had to design and build an aquaponic system that should be as sustainable as possible, and that should support both fish and plant culture based on water recirculation. So they could make something for a farm, they could make something for industry, but they decided to make it for the household markets. And the system should monitor or control some important system parameters, ensuring some good conditions for the fish and for the plants, like the pH, the temperature, and stuff like that, and the prototype budget was just 250 euros. So we usually work with very low budgets because we could say, well, you have 10,000 euros, but if they have 10,000 euros, they won't use their brains. They will just expend the money on the something that they found that it's very expensive and stuff like that. So this way, we make them use their ideas, try to find the cheap materials, try to solve the problem with the low budgets. And they just have those mandatory requirements, that is to reuse provided components and low-cost software solutions, and also to comply with regulations on hazard products, machines directives and stuff like that. And so given this very open goal, they have to define first a thing that is their own set of conflict resolution rules. So every team, since they are a multinational team, they have different members, they have different backgrounds and stuff like that. They have to decide if on the group there is some problem, how they are going to solve it. That's the first thing that each team in EPS has to define. It's the team working with it. This team working with it is signed by all team members, and if in the future there is some problem, they have their, it's their constitution, how to solve the problem. And then they also have to create their work plan and the Gantt chart. They have to divide the tasks between them, so everything is done by them. And then they also have to know, they start with an idea, and then they have to know the characteristics of the electrical components and materials that they are going to need for putting the system to work. For instance, here, they have to decide what would be the best fishes to grow with the plants, what would be the best plants, what kind of roots the plants should have and stuff like that, what kind of grow beds they should use. So everything is included in their study. And besides this, they also have to address the three spheres of sustainability that he spoke, like the environmental, economic and social impacts, and also have to make their product lifecycle analysis. So this is part of the sustainability problem. So they have to comply with this, and then they also have to define their marketing plan. So they make a best analysis, a SWOT analysis, and then they define strategic objectives, they perform the market segmentation, they define the positioning of the product, and define the marketing mix. So given all this study, is where they decide what they are going to do. And then, as always, they have a logo. In this case, it's fish food. So this logo is their brand, and it's also what motivates them to develop their project. So this team, they decided to target the European Union household market. And this is mainly because they think that searched and they investigated that, and they found out that the organic food production is gaining some popularity mainly in the Western region, in Europe, the United States, also in Australia. But since they saw that there were some competitors in Australia and in the USA and no competitors in the European Union, so they decided to focus their attention on the European markets. And so after that, they also consider some ethical issues surrounding their product. Okay, so this is also something that they have to make, and this is very important. We are all now aware of that problem that arose with Volkswagen. So if they are going to make a new product, if they are going to sell this product, if they are stating that this product is sustainable, they have to check the implications of all these statements and of everything that they develop, and so they have to address all these kinds of ethics and also intellectual property rights aspects and liability aspects if they are going to sell a product or introduce a product into the market. And so, given all this, they get to this design. So it's a relatively simple design. They decided to put the aquarium transparent with some like a box, what we call a grow bed, on top of it. On the back there is some protuberance for the electronics, and they can grow the plants on top of the aquarium. So this is their final design. And then they decided to assemble the product. They bought all the components, they assembled it, and then they developed a set of functional tests and they proved that the product was working. So they pumped the water from the tank into the grow bed. Water then went down again to the tank. It took some time for that process to occur because the plant roots must get the nutrients they have also, let's say, a short circuit system in case the system, the pump is always working. They have to be sure that they have an opening for the water to go down to the tank again. So they developed all these experimental tests. They check that the system worked, and this is their final product. Okay? So we have an aquarium on the bottom. We have the plants on the top. And on this second iteration, the electronics are outside of the tank because they had some problems on the first prototype. It's always the same, but this is how they learn. So
what,
yes, the electronics are out.
And water,
yes.
Don't mix.
Yes. Anyway, this PC system has been running successfully for over 1 year.
Yes, it's
been
in my office.
Yes, it has been in a presentation this weekend,
yes,
at Porto, and it has sustained 6 fish and 2 ornamental plants, and the plants have already been pruned several times because they are growing a lot. So they have a product that is working. Okay, so concluding. Their main objective was to create a working system that supported both fish and plant cultures, and they have developed an entire product with ethical questions on mind, sustainability questions on mind, and what they state is that they have completed the requirements and also expanded so that the system is successful within the intended target markets, and has also an aesthetic design. Well, this is their opinion, and a simple functionality. And they also state something more, is that they, through their design stages and using all their these aspects, ethics, marketing, and so on, they found that it was possible to create a simple product that fitted their needs. And they also found that from the initial brainstorming to the final renders, our ideas of a successful and quality aquaponic system had changed fast. So that's what I was saying. They imagined the electronics on the top, then they had a box outside. So everything makes them know. And this knowledge was gained mostly through research, and we believe that this led to the creation of a desirable and functioning system. Okay, so this is their opinion. And I have just here a very small video also to present.
Oh yes, I wish I was a fish, because I really love to swim. I'd go swimming underwater with old King Neptune's daughter. Yes, I wish I was a fish. Fishy, fishy, ooh.
Fishy, fishy, ooh.
Fishy, fishy, ooh. Fishy, fishy, ooh. Go swimming underwater with old King Neptune's daughter. Yes, I wish I was a fish. Oh yes, I wish I was a fish, born with gills. That would be really silly. I'd go swimming underwater with old. Yes, I wish I was a fish. Fishy, fishy.